Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the voltage series feedback topology in detail. So in the last couple of videos on the feedback amplifier, we have seen the general structure of the feedback amplifier and we have also seen the effect of the negative feedback on the amplifier. And then we have discussed the four different feedback topologies. That is the voltage series, voltage shunt, current shunt and the current series feedback. So in this specific video, we will talk about the voltage series feedback topology in detail. So in this voltage series feedback, we have seen that there is a voltage sampling and the series mixing. That means on the output side, the voltage signal is sampled and on the input side, through a series mixing, this feedback voltage is subtracted from the source signal. So this feedback topology is also known as the voltage-voltage feedback. Because here on the output side, the voltage signal is sampled and on the input side also, this voltage signal is mixed with the source signal. And based on the connection, sometimes it is also known as the series shunt feedback topology. Because here, in this topology, on the input side or on the mixing side, we have the series connection, while on the output side or on the sampling side, we have the shunt connection. So in the previous video, we have also seen that this type of feedback is mainly suitable for the voltage amplifiers. Because in this type of feedback, the input signal is voltage and the output is also voltage. And then we have also seen that in this topology, since there is a series mixing on the input side, so the input impedance of this feedback amplifier will increase. And likewise, on the output side, since we have the shunt connection, so the output impedance of this feedback amplifier will reduce. That means if the RI is the input impedance of this basic voltage amplifier, then with the feedback, this input impedance will increase by the factor of 1 plus A beta. And similarly, if this R0 is the output impedance of this basic voltage amplifier, then with the feedback, it will reduce by the factor of 1 plus A beta. So now, let us see that in this feedback topology, how the input impedance increases and how the output impedance reduces. So here is the ideal structure of the voltage series feedback amplifier, where this A circuit shows the ideal amplifier block and this beta circuit shows the ideal feedback network. So here in this amplifier circuit, this RI is the input impedance of the amplifier and this A is the gain of this voltage amplifier. That means if Vi is the input to this amplifier, then it will get amplified by the factor of A. So here, for the simplicity, it has been assumed that this voltage source is ideal and its source resistance RS is equal to 0. Likewise, on the output side, this R0 is the output impedance of the amplifier and this Vout is the output voltage. Similarly, this beta circuit is the feedback network. So here, this feedback network samples the output voltage and a fraction of the output voltage is sent back to the input side. So here, it has been assumed that this feedback network does not load the amplifier. That means after connecting this feedback network, the output of this basic amplifier does not get loaded. So here, this beta times V0 is the fraction of the output voltage which is sent back to the input side. And on the input side through a series mixing, it is subtracted from the source signal. So now, let us find out the effective input impedance with the feedback. So here, let's say this IN is the current that is flowing from the source side. So here, after the feedback, the effective input impedance which is seen from the source side is equal to Vs divided by IN, or that is equal to RIF. That is the input impedance of the amplifier with the feedback. So basically, to find that, here we need to find the ratio of this Vs divided by IN. So here, if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can write this Vi is equal to Vs minus Vf. And as you can see over here, this Vf is equal to beta times V0. So we can say that this Vi is equal to Vs minus this beta times V0. And here, since the same current IN is flowing through the Vi, so we can say that this Vi is equal to this IN times RI. So we can say that this IN times RI is equal to Vs minus this beta times V0. And as you can see over here, this output voltage V out is equal to 8 times V in. So further we can write it as this I in times RI, that is equal to Vs minus this A times beta times Vi. And we know that this Vi is equal to I in times RI. So further we can write it as this I in times RI, that is equal to Vs minus this A beta times I in times RI. So now if we take this term on the left hand side, then we can write it as this 1 plus A beta times this I in times RI, that is equal to Vs. Or we can say that this Vs divided by I in, that is equal to this RI times 1 plus A beta. So as you can see, now this Vs divided by I in, that is equal to this RI times 1 plus A beta. So as you can see with the feedback, now this input impedance of the amplifier will increase by the factor of 1 plus A beta. And in this way, this effective input impedance of this feedback amplifier will increase. And this is actually happening because we have the series connection on the mixing side. So similarly, now let us find out the output impedance with the feedback. So to find the output impedance, we will set the source voltage Vs as 0 and we will apply the test voltage at the output side. So let's say this test voltage is equal to Vx. So now if Ix is the current that is flowing from the source Vx, then this output impedance with the feedback or this ROF can be given as this Vx divided by Ix. So basically, here to find the effective output impedance, we need to find the ratio of the Vx and the Ix. So now, if you observe over here, then the sampled signal by this feedback network is equal to Vx. Or we can say that over here, this feedback voltage Vf is equal to beta times Vx. And here, if you apply the KVL in this loop, then we can say that here this Vi is equal to minus Vf. So now, if we apply the KVL in this loop, then we can write this Vx is equal to this R0 times Ix plus A times Vi. And here, we know that this Vi is equal to minus Vf and this Vf is equal to beta times Vx. So we can say that this Vx is equal to this R0 times Ix minus A times beta times Vx. So further we can say that this Vx times 1 plus A beta, that is equal to this R0 times Ix. Or further we can write it as this Vx divided by Ix, that is equal to this R0 divided by 1 plus A beta. So as you can see, now this ratio of Vx and the Ix is equal to R0 divided by 1 plus A beta. That means with the feedback, now this effective output impedance will reduce by the factor of 1 plus A beta. And that is actually happening because we have the shunt connection on the output side. Because on the shunt connection, the output impedance will reduce. So in this way, in this voltage series feedback, the output impedance will reduce by the factor of 1 plus A beta and the input impedance will increase by the same factor. And for this feedback amplifier, effectively, this is how the equivalent circuit will look like. So for a voltage amplifier, the increase in the input impedance and the reduction in the output impedance is the desired thing. Because if you see the actual circuits, then in the actual circuit, we will also have this source resistance. So in this case, if we see the effective voltage that is applied to the amplifier or this Vi is equal to RIF divided by this RIF plus RS times Vs. That means the effective input voltage which is appearing across the amplifier can be given by this expression. And as you can see, in this voltage series feedback, since the input impedance increases, so the effective input voltage which is appearing across the amplifier will also increase. And that is what is required for the voltage amplifier. That means the voltage amplifier should have a high input impedance so that whatever source signal is applied to the amplifier that appears across the amplifier. Similarly, in the actual amplifiers, we will also have the load resistor. So in that case, if we see the effective output voltage which is appearing across the load voltage or this VOL, then that is equal to RL divided by this ROF plus RL times AF times VI. So in this case, we want that the maximum output voltage should appear across the load resistor. And for that to happen, this output impedance of the amplifier should be minimum. So in this voltage series feedback, since the output impedance reduces, so more voltage will appear across the load resistor. So that is the desired thing for the voltage amplifier. And that is why this feedback topology is suited for the voltage amplifier. So now let us see in the actual circuits how this voltage series feedback is implemented. So as you know, in the voltage series feedback, we have a voltage sampling at the output side. So in the actual circuits, to sample the output voltage, we can use the resistor divider. For example, in the given op-amp circuit, the output voltage is sampled using the voltage divider circuit. So here, this feedback voltage VF is equal to R1 divided by this R1 plus R2 times Vout. And similarly, if we have a MOSFET based amplifier circuit, then also using the voltage divider, the output voltage can be sampled. So similarly, now let us see in the actual circuits how to do the series mixing. So in the series mixing, basically we are subtracting the feedback voltage from the source voltage. So here, this non-inverting op-amp configuration is one of the examples for the series mixing. So here, this feedback voltage VF is connected to the negative terminal of the op-amp, and this input signal is connected to the positive terminal. So this op-amp will amplify the difference between the two input signals. So in the op-amp based circuits, this is how the series mixing is achieved. Similarly, in the transistor based circuits, a single transistor connects as a voltage subtractor. So here, if the input is applied at the gate of the MOSFET and the feedback signal is applied to the source terminal of the MOSFET, then as you can see, this VGS is equal to Vin minus VF. So in this way, a single transistor can act as a voltage subtractor. Or alternatively, we can also apply the feedback signal to the gate terminal. So in this case, the feedback signal is applied to the gate terminal while the input signal is applied to the source terminal. So in this case, if you see, then this voltage VGS is equal to VF minus Vin. So in any case, using a single transistor, it is possible to subtract the two voltages. So apart from that, to subtract the two voltages, we can also use the differential pair. So here, one of the input to the differential pair is equal to Vin, while the other input is equal to VF. And in this way, it is possible to perform the series mixing. So based on this, this non-inverting configuration of the op-amp is one of the examples for the voltage series feedback. So here, using a voltage divider, the output voltage is sampled, and on the input side, this op-amp is performing the series mixing. Similarly, this is the another example of the voltage series feedback. So here, as you can see, using a voltage divider, the voltage signal is sampled and it is connected back to the gate terminal of the MOSFET. And here, the input signal is applied to the source terminal. So here, basically this MOSFET will perform the series mixing. That means here, this VGS is equal to VF minus Vin. So in this way, here this MOS transistor is performing the voltage subtraction. So of course, this circuit is performing the voltage sampling and the series mixing. But the only thing that we need to confirm is that whether we have a negative feedback in the circuit or not. Because we have seen that in all these topologies, we need to have the negative feedback. So for this circuit, let us find the polarity of the feedback. So here, let's say due to some reason, this input voltage Vin increases. So if this input voltage Vin increases, then as you can see, here this VGS, that is Vf minus Vin will reduce. So we can say that when the Vin increases, then this VGS will reduce. And if you have followed my earlier videos on the MOSFET, then you must be aware that when the VGS reduces, then this drain current ID will also reduce. So we can say that when the VGS reduces, then this drain current ID will reduce. And if the drain current ID reduces, then the voltage drop across this resistor RD will also reduce. That means now, the more voltage will be available at the output side. So we can say that now this output voltage Vout will also increase. And if this output voltage Vout increases, then this feedback voltage Vf will also increase. And if this Vf increases, then this voltage Vgs will also increase. So because of that, now the drain current ID will increase and the drop across the resistor RD will also increase. And now eventually, the output voltage will reduce. So as you can see over here, the increase in the input voltage tries to increase the output voltage, but the feedback tries to reduce the increase in this output voltage. So certainly, here we have the negative feedback. So in short, to check the polarity, what we can do? If the increase in the input voltage also increases the feedback voltage, then we can say that the given feedback is the negative feedback. That means if the Vf changes in the same direction as the input voltage, then we can say that in the circuit, we have the negative feedback. So similarly, in the first circuit also, let us confirm whether we have a negative feedback or not. So in this circuit, whenever this Vs voltage increases, then this Vs minus Vf will increase. Or in other words, this differential input voltage will increase. So due to that, this output voltage Vout will also increase. And if this output voltage increases, then this feedback voltage Vf will also increase. So due to that, now this differential input voltage, that is Vs minus Vf, will reduce. So we can say that if the Vout increases, then this differential input voltage Vid will reduce. And because of that, eventually, this output voltage Vout will also reduce. So as you can see over here, when the Vs increases, then this feedback voltage Vf will also increase. And here, since both have the same polarity, so we can say that there is a negative feedback in the circuit. So this is how in the actual circuits, this voltage series feedback is implemented. So I hope in this video, you understood how in this voltage series feedback, the input impedance increases and the output impedance reduces. And how this feedback topology is actually implemented in the circuits. So similarly, in the next video, we will cover the voltage shunt feedback. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.